Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today I want to talk about a new feature in Dropbox that allows you to use Dropbox as remote storage. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a community of supporters. Join us and get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. So the problem with cloud storage is that it doesn't necessarily save space on your hard drive. Matter of fact, it may take up more space. For instance, if you save a file on your desktop Mac, that file will sync to your laptop Mac and take up space on both drives. Now, a lot of times that's what we want. We want the file to be everywhere. But sometimes you want to actually just take a file and get it off your drives completely, store it in the cloud, and not have a local copy. This can save space on your drive and allow you to archive old files that you probably don't need anymore, but you don't want to completely throw away.
So the new feature introduced in Dropbox is something that's part of the Plus or Professional individual plan, and it's called Dropbox Smart Sync. If you go to your Dropbox preferences, you'll find a control for this under Sync and then Save Hard Drive Space Automatically, and you can turn it on or off. Fortunately, you have to turn it on or off for the entire account, not just a selected folder, which would be nice. So this isn't actually what I'm that excited about, because turning this on basically makes it like iCloud Drive but with Optimize turned on. Things will automatically get offloaded and save you space as files get older and you don't use them anymore. That's not that exciting to me. What's more exciting to me is that you can now manually set a file or folder to be offline only. Now when you go to set this up, it'll ask you to install an extension for your Mac, and once you do that, if you control click on something, like I have this Archives folder here in my Dropbox folder, and I've got Smart Sync, and you can see I could switch it between local and online only. Local is just like before. I have a local copy of this folder and all of its contents at all times, but online only will actually remove it from my local hard drive and store it remotely. As you can see, this Archives folder is 145 gigs and the entire thing is set, and you can tell by this icon here, to be remote only. So that means these archives are not taking up any space on my drive, yet I can still access all the files in them. It's far from perfect because it seems like you have to set this manually all the time. So, for instance, if I were to take this folder here that has a file in it, move that to Dropbox, and now it's there, it's going to sync it, and that file you can see is now set to be local. I could select the folder, change the folder to online only, and it will change the folder and all the files in it to be online only. Now if I move a second file in there, you'd think that that would be online only since that's what the folder is set to, but nope, that one's going to be local as well. I have to either change that so that that individual file is online only or reset the folder again to online only for everything. So that's annoying. I love for a folder to be able to just be online only, and anything I put in there automatically becomes online only. So if we look back in the preferences, we can see under Sync there was the option to have new content default set to online only. But that clearly wasn't working, so I'm not sure if that's a bug or maybe I don't understand that selection. Also, of course, I don't know if I'd want to have this as the default for the entire account, because I still want to use Dropbox normally. I just want to have an archive folder where I can offload things. Another serious problem is even though I set this Docs folder to be offline only here, I added some stuff to it, I had to go and set it to be offline only again, and it all seems to be good now. It's actually not good because my laptop actually shows these as being local. So I have to go to my laptop now and tell my laptop also that these should be offline only. And that's a real pain if you're adding, say, several gigabytes of stuff to archive. You have to set it to offline only, wait for it to sync on your laptop, and set that to offline only. You could do that before the sync is complete, but you basically have to have both your machines in front of you in order to archive something. Otherwise, the other one is going to download everything you've archived before you get a chance to say you want that to be offline only.
So you may have noticed another feature there in their preferences called Selective Sync. And this is an old feature, it's been around for a while, that you could also use for offline storage. For that, what you do is put a bunch of stuff in Dropbox and then take that folder and say I don't want it to sync to this computer, and it disappears. So those files are no longer stored in your computer, but you can't see them either. The only way to see them is to go to Dropbox.com. And you still have to go to your other machines and tell them that you also don't want to see that folder there, or all that data is going to sync to those machines as well. So in a way it's got the same flaw. This new feature is nice in that you can still see the files and get quick access to them when you need them. But it's still really clunky to use as true offline storage, which is a shame now that Dropbox gives you 2 terabytes of data for your Plus plan. It would be nice to use that rather than putting your archives on old aging hard drives that you stick in a drawer somewhere until they break. I'd love to see Dropbox either improve this feature so it could be used better for offline storage, or maybe add a new folder type that can be set to be offline storage and behave properly.
I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.